Question and answer on natural resources. Why is the atmosphere essential for life? Now, atmosphere is responsible or essential for life. Why? Because it is maintaining the appropriate climate, the temperature, the environment for the sustenance of life. And this life is not only us, but all the flora and fauna, all the organisms, all the plants. So atmosphere keeps the average temperature of the earth fairly constant during the daytime, and it prevents sudden decrease or sudden increase in temperature during the daytime and nighttime. And it also slows down the escape of heat from the surface of earth into outer space during nighttime. What happens if this is earth? Then the rays from sun, they come and they may be absorbed, they may be reflected. Now we need this energy. So atmosphere is responsible for containing this energy so that our earth is warmer, somewhat warmer, so that the life, whether it be plants or animals, they may live or they may exist. Why is water essential for life? Water is everywhere. You know, you can think that if you don't get water, if you are thirsty, what will happen? So water is essential for life. There are certain reasons for this. First, most biological reactions, they occur when substances are dissolved in water. That means all cellular processes need water as a medium to take place. The next is transportation. The transportation of biological substances, they need water as a medium. Next is, how are living organisms dependent on the soil? Are organisms that live in water totally independent of soil as a resource? See, the living organisms, whether, you know, they are herbivorous, carnivorous, they depend directly or indirectly on the soil, right? And those who are living in aquatic, they are more dependent. How? All the living organisms, they depend on soil. Some directly, some indirectly. So we start with the plant. The plant needs soil for getting support or growing, as well as nutrients to prepare their food. If you take organisms, they depend on these plants for food and also other substances, you know, plant products for their life. Herbivores, they depend directly upon plants. They eat plants. And carnivores, they eat herbivores. That is, they are also dependent on plant, because carnivores depends on these animals which are herbivores, which are eating food, eating plant as a food. So this makes them dependent on soil indirectly. And those who live in water, the organisms, the flora and fauna in water, they are not totally independent of soil as a resource, because they don't need that soil. But these organisms, they require food and other substances. And these aquatic plants, they require minerals for their sustenance. From where these minerals are going to come? These minerals are carried to water bodies from soil, by rivers, by rainwater. And if you don't supply, or if there is no supply of minerals from the soil to water bodies, we cannot imagine aquatic life. It is impossible to imagine the aquatic life. You have seen weather reports on television and newspaper. How do you think we are able to predict the weather? Nowadays, we are able to predict the weather for years. What is going to happen after 2 years? You can predict that. How? The meteorological department. This meteorological department, mostly, you know, in various countries, these are government owned. They collect data on the elements of weather, such as it may be maximum, minimum temperatures, maximum, minimum humidity, rainfall or speed. So they are able to study these elements using various, you know, state-of-the-art instruments. Now, the maximum and minimum temperature of a day is measured by thermometer, which is known as maximum minimum thermometer. The rainfall is measured by rain gauge. The wind speed is measured by anemometers. And there are different, as I said, state-of-the-art instrument which is used to measure humidity as well. Next is, we know that many human activities lead to increasing level of pollution of the air, water bodies, and soil. So, do you think that if you isolate these activities to specific, some constrained area or limited area, that would help in reducing pollution? Well, the answer is partially yes and partially no. We'll answer it as yes, because, you know, if you have an industry here and you are living here, you will be directly affected. But if industry is here and you are living, say, 100 kilometers apart or far from it, the effect will be less, but still the effect will be there. So, isolating human activities to specific areas would help in reducing level of pollution. For example, setting up of industries in isolated region will control pollution to some extent. And the pollution caused by these industries directly will not contaminate the water resources, the agricultural land, the fertile land, and this area will be, you know, somewhat safer than this area. Write a note on how forests influence the quality of air, soil and water sources. So the forest, they influence and they greatly influence the quality of air, soil and water. Some of them, like forests are responsible for balancing the percentage of carbon dioxide, CO2 and oxygen in the atmosphere, right? Because of human activities, not even we are breathing, the industry is the activities, the setups we have made, the establishments we have made, there is increasing amount of carbon dioxide, and which is balanced by larger intake of carbon dioxide by plants, because plants during photosynthesis, the process of making food, it intakes the carbon dioxide and then take out or give you out oxygen. So large amount of oxygen is released in this process. Forests prevent soil erosion, right? If you have straight soil, the wind and air will take the upper soil crust. But if you have plants here, or you know, the trees, then the root of plant will bind the soil tightly in a way that the surface of the soil cannot be eroded by wind or water. This is again a very good help from forest. Then the water resources replenishment or refurbishment or recharge. So, forest help in replenishment of water resources. During the process of transpiration, a huge amount of water vapor, it goes into the air, it condenses to form the cloud, and then cloud gives you rainfall, and that will recharge the water bodies. So, these are question and answer.